A lot of game design, it's basically trial and error. We call it iteration, but it's trial and error. We just have to see whether or not it works, and then we go back to the drawing board. It's a difficult process and very hard to predict. I really want to enable game designers to create better games and be more efficient about what they do. I'm Joris Dormans. I'm a game designer, and I'm a co-founder at Machinations.io. When I went to university, I first thought I was going to be an architect. But I wanted to do actually more with computers and the new media stuff, games. So I actually switched to cultural studies. I decided, okay, once I got my master's degree, I actually wanted to do a PhD in game design. During that process of doing the PhD, Machinations came into being because I was reading in the works of Ernest Adams about internal economy and feedback loops. That really clicked for me at the time. And I thought, okay, this is what I need to focus on, because it's a pretty invisible structure in games. And if I can somehow visualize that, that will really help students and other people, practitioners of game design, to understand the dynamics of the thing that they're working with. So I was first looking at UML type diagrams, but that didn't really work for me. I said it was overly complicated, and I started to simplify that until I ended up with a very lean system with just a few symbols that really foregrounds the structure of those feedback loops. And that really helps explaining to yourself, understanding the dynamics of the game that you're working on. I was working on those diagrams, and there was a game designer called Stefan Burat reached out to me and said, there's a lot of people that are trying to do what you do, but you're doing it better than we are. And he was actually the person that suggested that I make it into an interactive tool. When I started making first software implementation of Machinations, I chose to use Flash. There was no download. You could just go to a website and see these moving diagrams immediately. And I think that really helped getting traction, even though Flash at the time was a little bit notorious. It's still, those early Flash tools, they're still special to me. When I was wrapping up my PhD, I actually had the opportunity to meet Ernest Adams, and I showed him what I've done with the idea of eternal economy that he put in his book. And he really jumped on the opportunity to collaborate with me, write a book, and go to GDZoo and talk. And at the time, Mihai and Dana reached out to me and said, hey, we saw your Machinations and we really love it, and we want to build a company around that. Are you okay with that? And can we meet up? So yeah, that's what we did. And I gave them my blessing, and they took it from there. Since the company started, it's grown immensely, and way beyond what I could ever imagine. It's been used in 300 universities worldwide. The community is 60,000 registered users, 30 plus people working on this idea that I had 10 years ago. What I hope that Machinations will do is improve the way that we make games, so we can be more effective and efficient about designing these dynamic systems. The ultimate result of that is better games. At least that's what I hope. If I look back at the whole journey, it just makes me very proud. There's no way you can predict when you're doing your PhD that there's a company coming out of this. It's almost humbling, but it's just immensely proud.